Hey, it's Fran. Again. Another one of these commentary videos. Because I've accumulated some data, and it's given me some insight into the inner workings of YouTube and how YouTube selects the videos. I did a video a couple months ago, called WTF YouTube, where I outlined the ways that I found out that YouTube had sort of pulled my videos out of circulation outside of my subscribership, and it was in the aftermath of that video that I found out that one of the reasons that my channel was doing so poorly was that one of the changes that YouTube had installed was that even though at the time I had like 60,000 subscribers, that a lot of my subscribers, maybe even the bulk of my subscribers, were completely unaware of the new videos because YouTube was not even notifying people who had already subscribed to my channel that I was still making content. So apparently there's a little bell that you gotta click on to actually get notifications, and a lot of people, thousands of them, commented that although they were subscribed, they were not getting notifications that I was making new videos, and I had to click that little belly thing. But in the time since then, I've gained some more data because my channel got quite a surge after that WTF video for lots of reasons. I mean, there's been a lot of drama the last few months. I made that video talking about how YouTube had shelved my channel, and then as a result of that video getting very popular, my channel got a new insurgence of subscribers, so I got like 25,000 new subscribers. And I got lots of bumps. I got bumps from Dave Jones, and I got bumps from Big Clive. And a lot of activity, even just in the last few weeks. And because I had several rant videos where I talked about the lip, because I got an eviction notice after like a couple weeks after doing that WTF video. So and I've been looking for properties. And then there was the demolition and the okay. So all this drama. So it's very hard for me to actually sift through all this data and try to find out what YouTube is thinking. After looking at the data, which I'm going to show you in a moment if you want to stick around, I've come to think that YouTube has a very different idea of what this channel is than what I try to make it. Because Fran Lab is supposed to be a vintage electronics educational channel, talking about vintage electronics and showing cool things and antique mechanical things, and you know, doing some tours of things like organs and automatons and stuff. So that's kind of what I want the channel to be. But looking at the data, it's hard for me to get around the perception that YouTube thinks that my channel is supposed to be a sort of FaceTime rant channel. Let me go to the data and show you what I mean. Here's a chart that shows my views from first week of July this year up till 11th of November, so pretty much this week. And this is that period where I had noticed in September that my channel was not getting seen outside of my immediate subscribership, and these peaks here are individual videos that I was putting up during the summertime. And this is the surge that I've had since the WTF video, but this doesn't really tell you much, so let me take the same chart annotated. Okay. This is the annotated chart with some notes showing the various videos that came out and the response. This is just views. So here's the WTF video that I put up, and over the course of that week or so, it got a lot of views, and most of these views were outside of my subscribership, but also people who were subscribers to my channel were discovering that they were not getting notifications of these videos and had to click that bell thing and actually like, and other people, there are also many hundreds, maybe thousands of people who found that over the course of the last, you know, months or years that they had been automatically unsubscribed and had to, and in rediscovering my channel through the WTF video that had been circulated, discovered that I was not in their subscriptions list, and so they found they had to resubscribe to my channel. But all that happened right here. And then on the sort of the other side of that, I did the viewer mail number 10 that was sort of on the downslope here, and then down here I did the flat tire video down in this cusp, and then this is my end of Fran Lab eviction notice video, got this spike, and then I had a little lull there because I was moving stuff to storage, I wasn't making videos, but this little area here, this area of activity, this little mountain, this is my rants videos series. I did like 10 videos in a row here about the mortgage rants, monetization rants, all that. And around this time here, I turned on the monetization for the first time. And on the end here is the last week or so. That's my new camera video and the Zaxxon video that I did. So these are the rants here. Rants, 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 rants. These are my, and I got back to doing regular videos here the last week or so, the new camera video, the Zaxxon upright video, and these have kind of, I mean, it's a little bulkier than in August, but basically like the same peak viewing, you know, video reaches its maximum viewership, and you know, in the first 48 to 72 hours or so, and so the peaks here of the videos I was making in the summertime, it's about the same peak viewership as what I'm getting now, even after all this. So let's take a close-up of this more recent area of the chart. Okay, so this is a magnification of that area of just the views, but I thought it'd be handier to show these views because I turned monetization on here. And so let me get the other chart that has that. Okay, so this is the big chart. This is views in the background from the second week of October to November the 10th. So it's about a month, about the last month. This is where the video that Big Clive gave me the bump about Fran Lab. Thanks, Clive. And this is the Dave bump where Dave did the video about my mortgage hassles that I was having and about problems of being self-employed and all that. So I got some bumps there, but this hump here is around the time that I did the mortgage rant, and that's Dave's follow-up to the mortgage rant. This is where I started the ads, right here. This is like a 24-hour period, 48-hour period here where I was going through and turning on ads for various videos in the catalog. Over the course of a couple days, I sort of picked them out and turned them on gradually, but at this point, I've got the monetization on all the videos I was going to monetize, and that's also corresponding to around the time I did the monetization rant, because I did the mandatory monetization rant here, and I decided, well, let's turn it on and see what happens, so I did the selective videos here, and then people were saying, well, just turn on all the videos to ads, which I did not do, but I turned on more, and that was sort of where I finalized it here. And a little notch here, but that's pretty steady, right, for like a week here, where the ad revenue was going to be, you know, pretty constant with a little divot there. But here, this is the point where I did a video of announcing new rules for viewer mail, right? Now that video, it got a lot of attention very quickly. I think the first 5 hours, it got 6,000 views or 5,000, 5 or 6,000 views in the first 5 hours. And the commentary and the comments were surprisingly negative, bordering on vitriolic. I clearly was not sending the message. People, I guess, were being notified outside of my subscribership, people who did not know anything about my channel or what I did, and they were saying, oh, you know, if you're not going to open your packages, you're a coward, and people were quoting Benjamin Franklin saying, those who want security and liberty deserve neither, and it was like this patriot fest of, you know, calling me weak and saying that I was a child and I was acting childish and, you know, that, you know, my channel was going in the toilet, that, you know, and so I felt, well, either these people don't understand what my channel's about or I'm sending the wrong message. Whatever the reason, I decided to take that video down and rethink the approach on the viewer mail, which I did, and I posted another video like a week later clarifying exactly what I wanted to do. But when I took that video down, look what happened to the revenue. This is the whole channel, not just like for one video. I took that video down and in 24 hours, the revenue for the whole channel dropped two-thirds. And then in the next 2 days, it dropped again. And viewership on the whole channel just fell off too after I removed that video. So it was really weird. It was almost like, well, it's like, is this just because the momentum from these rants is ceasing? Or was this like a penalty for removing a video that was very popular and had a lot of engagement, all of it negative, but I took that video out, and was this sort of an algorithmic punishment for removing the video? I don't know. But it's been, for the last week, the ad revenue has remained, you know, sort of proportional to viewership, but channel views and everything are back to kind of where they were in September, because I'm not ranting, you see. So let me put a finer point on this. Okay, so here's the top 10 videos on my channel as of today. Number one, the NimmoTube, a video that I made over a year ago. It's got 500,000 views on it, and I don't know why that thing is so popular or why YouTube is continuing to promote it, but my face appears on that video a lot more than most of my videos. Okay, so NimmoTube, no mortgage for FranLab, mandatory monetization video, the riffraff need not apply, finding a new home for FranLab video, my air pollution solution to the demolition, stunned by GoFundMe thank you video, from Freddy to FranLab on a Friday vlog, the GoFundMe update. Those are the top 10 videos today. Today. Out of those top 10, there are only two that have anything to do with electronics. There's the NimmoTube video from a year ago, and the Frantone Vibratron alignment video that I did last week, which is not a FranLab video, but in fact a Frantone video. So, that's getting attention because of the fact it's a Frantone video. So what does all of this say about what YouTube thinks my channel is all about? Well, one thing I can say for sure is that the one thing that all 10 of these top 10 videos that YouTube is promoting today have in common is that my face appears in absolutely all of them. The videos that I do where I just show my bench and an interesting thing on the bench and do commentary over top of it, those videos never reach these kinds of viewerships. Those videos get 10,000 views or less, even with 88,000 subscribers. So, yeah, what does that mean? So yeah, it's hard for me to really discount what looks like the obvious, that videos that my face appears in get highly preferred, not just within my subscribership, but outside of my channel. Because there are no videos that I've made that have gotten any kind of significant views that don't show my face. That NimmoTube video that I made over a year ago, which ponderously has like 500,000 views, where that video gets 500,000 views, and the other videos that I make that are subjects that are maybe equally interesting, although not as rare, get like 10,000, 15,000 views and die. Why these magnificent differences in the viewership of my videos? Well, the difference is that if I do a video where my face is on camera, most of the time, those videos get a lot more views, like 4 times, 5 times, 10 times the views than if I just show my bench and show something cool on the bench. It really is it's hard to avoid the association with the fact that these videos that are really pushed are the ones where I don't show any electronics at all, where it's just my face on the camera ranting. And so just to run down some basics, like, in the rants videos, like my WTF YouTube video is 190,000 views. My no riffraff video about selective apartment buildings that only want certain kinds of people is 25,000 views. My end of FranLab eviction notice video is 70,000 views. My mandatory monetization rant videos has 30,000 views today. My mortgage issues video has 40,000 views. My GoFundMe thank you video has 40,000 views. None of those videos have anything to do with electronics or Fran Lab. They're just me ranting about things that are going on in the background. And they got these huge view numbers. And in the same time period, my Nixie 2 module video that I did, which I thought was going to be gangbusters, 16,000 views. My Display Innovations 1973 video that I did from that stuff that was sent in viewer mail, 10,000 views. My Big Iron Real Nixie Power Supply video, 14,000 views. My Scope X-Rays Analysis video, 10,000 views. The Zaxxon Upright video, which I did a week ago, 14,000 views. But all of these videos that I did that are Fran Lab related, they have like half or a quarter of the views of the rant videos that are done at the same time. So what is YouTube promoting? See, all that breakdown and analysis that they give you in the Google Analytics, what they will not tell you, what they will not tell me, what I can't discern from that, what I can't know, is how many of my videos and which videos YouTube is actually showing to people and giving notifications about. It can't be universal that if I've got 88,000 subscribers to Fran Lab, and those people are subscribing to a channel that's supposed to be about electronics tech, that if I put up a video about a Fran Lab thing and it gets 10,000 views, and that same subscribership that's supposed to be about Fran Lab, the electronics channel, get the same notifications for a rant that I'm ranting about mortgages, and that gets 40,000 views, it doesn't make any sense. Because are those 88,000 people here to hear me rant about mortgages and why I can't get an apartment or why banks suck? I mean, is that what this channel is about? It's not supposed to be. But here is the end part of it. My concern is that if I go back in 2019 after I get this place moved and I make Fran Lab the channel that I want it to be, which is just a channel about cool electronics where I do little projects and I do my little teardowns and stuff. And if I do that, just that, and I'm getting 10 to 15,000 views per video, well, it's not going to be a sustainable channel, because even with the monetization on, even with, 1,200 or more patrons, it just doesn't seem like it would be a sustainable channel, because if I can't keep my patrons happy, if I can't bring in new patrons every month to replace the patrons that leave, which is an issue in the long run, because people aren't going to subscribe to a channel for years and years and years and decades. I mean, every month a certain number of people move on and do something else, and I have to have a broad enough reach in my channel to bring in people to replace those patrons to keep the channel going. So for the channel to be sustainable, not even grow, allow some income to do more with the channel over the long run, but just to be sustaining, I have to have more reach. If I could get 40,000 views on my electronics videos, well, that would be a no-brainer. Then, yeah, the channel would have the reach. I could make the content I want to make, and Fran Lab would just be a channel that would just continue. But as it is, my concern is that when we get into 2019, if I stop making these ridiculous rant videos that actually bring in viewers from outside the viewership, actually get my videos on the notifications list for subscribers, well, then the channel is just going to disappear again. So if it turns out that this video gets more than 20,000 views, then yeah, it's probably going to be a good indication that my concerns about content are not unjustified. And I might have to continue to make rant videos maybe every week just to keep the channel visible. Because my face has to be on the camera all the time for YouTube to promote me. And that's the straight poop from the discombobulated lab. I'm Fran. Thanks to all the patrons for hanging in there. You know who you are. and I thank you. See you around real soon.